Now, my name is Barry Wood. I'm Woodridge Farm Brewery in Nelson County, Virginia. Woodridge Farm Brewery differs in the way that we actually grow everything on site. Well, we have 300 acres here. As you can see, it's a great view. All our barley's planted here, raised here, combined here, cleaned here, malted here, brewed here, and served here. Right now, we have about 15 beers on tap. Well, the process is we raise a winter barley, which we plant usually in October, November, depending on weather circumstances. This year, we were late due to the dry weather. So it sits there and goes dormant over the winter, comes back in the spring. As soon as the barley is ready, we harvest it. It goes into our storage down here, which then gets augured into our malt house, which gets cleaned, goes into steep tanks, goes on the floor, where it's turned by hand for about a period of 4 to 5 days until fully modified. And when we determine that, then we push it off into a kiln, and we start a 24 to 36 hour drying process all the way up to 180 degrees to cure the barley. And then it goes into the next step, which is the brewing, which is done here in this building. We have right now a 7-barrel system. We're up to about 8 fermenters now, and that's the last step till it goes into the tap. When you're raising barley, weather has everything to do with it. Rain, temperature, everything. So we've been very lucky with our weather patterns that we've had for the last 3 years, and we've been very successful in our harvesting. We have some hops, but not enough to do what we need to do. So we buy most of our hops in. All our water comes from this site also. Since it started out as a test to see if we could actually malt barley here on the East Coast, and if the barleys that we had here would malt. And then I found out that Virginia Tech's been doing extensive research on this for quite a while, so we looked to them for some of the varieties that we now raise. Once we figured it was viable to do it, we built a malting facility, which we intended to be able to sell to lots of other breweries, but then we decided to go ahead with our own brewery, and now that takes most all the malt. So. There really is no typical day on a farm. Being as we have the brewery here, it's either planting season, harvest season, all the other property to keep up with. As far as brewing, the brews go in about one to two times a week. So we're on a 7-barrel system. We brew about once or twice a week. And that allows us to keep beers coming out all the time and replenishing whatever might be out. It just depends on where we are in the year, where we are in what we're doing. We're still expanding, so we're still building other buildings and pizza ovens and bakery and tiki bars outside, so we're still, there is no typical day. And we're expanding all the time. We get new customers all the time. We seem to have a pretty good rating on everything. Everybody comes, seems to have a good experience, so. When I first started this, I wasn't sure if it was gonna be me and you sitting here drinking beer and me and you in the world, so it'll, hopefully we'll get somewhere in between. That's about where we're at now. So we're getting busier all the time with different things that we have coming up. So since I'm not finished, it's still a lot of work. But just seeing it develop from the ground up, I guess, been the most rewarding. I like to build stuff, so that's what I get my happiness from, is building it. Well, we hope that they like the atmosphere that we create. It is a little different than some of the other breweries. I didn't set out to build a brewery under any kind of rule or law or anything else. I just kind of got it in my mind and went with it. So people seem to be very happy with what we've done so far. And they keep coming back to see where we're going next. So hopefully it should go along all right.